of the things that I think a Horn professorship does is that it conveys that you've been recognized by your peers. And I'm hopeful that this recognition has made an impact, that impact is not only on the students that I serve, but for the profession that I represent. This also indicates for the students that they're studying with a person whose work has been recognized by his or her peers as noteworthy.
Also, it's a sign that the university is serious about honoring excellence in scholarly and creative activities. And I think that means a lot to people who look at Texas Tech from the outside, that it's not only, you know, the football team or the basketball team. No one consciously sets out to be a Horn professor, since, although there are other criteria that are important, we certainly value good teaching and so on. It really is an award that recognizes excellence that has an impact internationally in one's own discipline in creative activity, scholarship, and research. And so I think the obvious thing is to take your passion and skills for whatever your discipline is and invest them in working hard and trying to be a success. And I think the Horn professorship will follow naturally as a consequence. I think if one lies in bed awake at night thinking about how one might become a Horn professor, that's not a very productive approach. It recognizes excellence. I think if one strives for excellence, it might well come naturally.
Find your professional home and stick with it, and then when the time is right, seek office. Don't join a whole slew of professional organizations. In other words, don't spread yourself too thin. I mean, a lot of colleagues, you look at they belong to like 8 societies. You can't really consistently attend 8 different societies. Although I belong to a few more, I only consistently attend 1 society. I kind of hang my hat there and establish myself. And I would think that would be the better way to go.